Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who creates, redeems, and sustains us in all of creation. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of word and sacrament in the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
On this fourth Sunday of Advent, as we think about the coming of Jesus Christ, we light the candle of love. How great is the love the Father has lavished on us, a quote from 1 John chapter 3. This is how God showed his love. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him, 1 John chapter 4. And then a quote from John chapter 13, the Gospel of John. A new commandment I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. All people will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. John chapter 13. Today we light our fourth candle on the Advent wreath, the candle of love. Join your hearts with me in prayer. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. With your abundant grace and might, free us from the sin that would obstruct your mercy, that willingly we may bear your redeeming love to all the world. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Light four candles to watch for Messiah. Let the light banish darkness. He is coming. Tell the glad tidings. Let your lights be shining.
Today's readings comes from Luke 1:46b through 55. This is Mary's song of praise, the Magnificat. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has also done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estates. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever." Here ends the lesson.
The Gospel according to Luke chapter 1, beginning with verse 26. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Waiting. We do a lot of waiting in our world. Waiting with anticipation, waiting with expectancy, great expectations. One of my favorite authors is Charles Dickens, and one of my favorite books by him, one of my favorite novels by him, is Great Expectations. I don't think I've ever been more anxious for a new year than I am this year, with all that we've had going on this past year, politically, medically, with the pandemic. We have a lot that we've been waiting for with expectation, hoping that this new year will be a better year. And as we sit on the fourth Sunday of Advent now, we have before us the Magnificat by Mary, Mary's announcement by Gabriel as Gabriel comes to her with this incredible news that she is highly favored by God and will be bearing the Christ child. And she is overwhelmed with that news, and she responds by saying, "Let it be according to me, let it be done to me according to your word." And she yields to God's plan of salvation for the entire world by saying, "Yes, I'm the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according, let it be done to me according to your word." What an awesome thing. What's amazing is that she is looking forward to the fulfillment of all God's promises, even though she doesn't necessarily completely comprehend or understand it, yet she sees it as having already been fulfilled. She is incredibly excited about what God is going to be doing. And the Magnificat, if you look at the Magnificat, if you think about what she's saying, is very social justice minded. And she sees God through Jesus leveling the field between the rich and the poor, the haves and the have-nots. And it's an amazing thing. Mary's Magnificat is a song about social justice. She is God's entry point for Messiah coming into the world. And she doesn't dwell on the theological. She goes immediately to the difference that Jesus makes in our world. That's incredible. That's incredible for you and for me. She is, in a very real sense, bearing God's Son for the world. In the same way that you and I, as children of the promise, people of the kingdom of God, bear Jesus for the world. You and I, in a very real sense, just like Mary, bear Jesus for the world by how we live and act and behave in our world, because Jesus becomes real in us and with us and through us. That's not something that we should lose sight of nor minimize by making it just theological. Jesus is real, and he is the reason for the season, but in a very real sense, think about it. You and I are the reason for the season. Through Jesus, God breaks the power of sin and death and evil. Through Jesus, God breaks the power of bad corruption, bad government, bad church. God takes on all that is evil, and he gives us the victory in Jesus. And yet you and I are in the kind of in the in-between times, because evil is still rampant in our world. Government is still evil. Church oftentimes plays a part in allowing that evil to continue. What's amazing is that hope that we have, that love that we experience through Jesus, is being made real in us and with us and through us. As we celebrate this fourth Sunday of Advent, as we are so close to celebrating once again Christmas, the joy and the hope and the love and the peace of Christmas, you and I yield ourselves, just like Mary did, to that faith, what Paul, the Apostle Paul, calls the obedience of faith. And we say, God, may we be your servants, just like Mary was your servant, and may we help that kingdom reality of hope and love and peace and joy be real, not only in our lives, but unfolding for the sake of the world, in us and with us and through us. That's my prayer for you and for me. Don't forget that this Christmas Eve we'll be celebrating an open house Christmas. You're invited to come celebrate communion. Pastor Rick and Pastor Reba and I will be there to offer communion to all who come. We'll be using the chalice with real wine, not this juice that comes in the prefabricated things. We'll be using the chalice and pouring it for you to the individual cups. So come and celebrate that with us. Merry Christmas to you. See you on Christmas Eve. God's blessings. We love you. Bye.
My soul cries out with a joyful shout that the God of my heart is great. And my spirit sings of the wondrous things he'll bring to the ones who wait. You fixed your sight on your servant's plight, and my weakness you did not spurn. So from east to west shall my name be blessed, could the world be about to turn. My heart shall sing of the day you bring, let the fires of your justice burn. Wipe away all tears, for the dawn draws near, and and the world is about to turn. Though I am small, my God, my all, your work great things in me, and your mercy will last from the depths of the past to the end of the age to be. Your very name puts the proud to shame, and to those who reward you good, you will show your might, put the strong to fight, for the world is about to turn. My heart shall sing of the day you bring, let the fires of your justice burn. Wipe away all tears, for the dawn draws near, and the world is about to